Okay, hi everyone, and welcome to another of my photo editing tutorials. In today's video, I'm going to look at image resolution, and hopefully I'm going to try to help you understand image resolution a lot better. Now, using Adobe Photoshop and Adobe Camera Raw, I'm going to show you how to check your image resolution. Certainly how to make sure that you are exporting and saving your image at its correct or maximum image resolution, and also how to change your image resolution when you need to, and of course in situations where you would need to change your image resolution. Okay, so let's get started. So in Adobe Photoshop, I'm going to open one of my RAW files into Adobe Camera Raw. Now, when you first buy your camera, you would have noticed, of course, and you would have looked for the resolution of the camera. Now, the resolution of the camera when you're buying it is usually quoted in megapixels. In this situation, this image was shot on a Canon EOS 5D Mark III, which has an image resolution of 22.1 megapixels. Okay, so what that actually means is that the sensor inside your camera can capture 22.1 million pixels. Okay, that is the maximum resolution of your camera and of your sensor, actually. But what usually you also see when you open it is this, and this is sometimes where people get confused, because you get this number here, 5760 times 3840. Now what that actually means is that's 5780 pixels across the longest side, in this case because it's a horizontal picture. That means from here to here there are 5760 pixels, and then from here to here on the shortest side there are 3840 pixels. Now, if you times that, if we use a calculator, okay, 5760 times 3840, we get 22.11848, basically 22.1 million pixels. So there are a total of 22.1 million pixels across this entire image. Okay, that's the maximum resolution. Now, if you know the resolution of your camera, so you know it's 22.1 million pixels, and then if you look down here in Adobe Camera Raw, if it doesn't say 22.1 million pixels, then there is something wrong with your settings. So if we click this down here, it brings up the Camera Raw preferences, and you want to go to the workflow button and image sizing. Now, what could happen if you don't have 22.1 million pixels or 30 million pixels or 25, whatever the resolution of your camera is, then chances are something here in the image sizing is set wrong. Now, if this is unchecked, which it should be, then it's the default here, that is the default megapixels, default resolution of your camera. Okay, if we check this, we can now actually change that. So if we check this now and say 1000 by 1000, and if we close this now, you see down here it's telling you it's 1000 along the longest side, 667 along the shortest side, and it's 0.7 megapixels. And if I export that now, then I'm not going to be exporting my image at its maximum resolution. So that's where you need to be very careful. Now, of course, there might be situations where you want to do this. Of course. Now, you can set, for example, here, width and height. You can set dimensions. You can change it from pixels to inches to centimeters. You can set just the long side, so it basically you can decide the maximum number of pixels you want on the long side, short side, or whatever you want to do. Okay, and here, resolution. Now this is sometimes where people get confused, because they see pixel count. What we just looked at there was actually pixel count. That is the number of pixels within your image. Now resolution, you often see this pixels per inch. 300 pixels per inch. That is actually exactly what it says. That means that within 1 inch of your image, there are going to be 300 pixels. Now, if we change this to 500, notice this doesn't change. All we're doing, we're not actually changing the number of pixels within your image when we change the resolution here. We're just changing how those pixels are spread. So instead of 300 pixels in an inch, we are going to put 500 pixels in an inch. And that would just mean that the image would print a bit smaller, but there's the same number of pixels within that image. It hasn't changed. Okay, now I'll explain that a bit more when we go into Photoshop. But really what I wanted to show you here was to check to make sure that, first of all, that is unchecked, so you will export your image at its maximum resolution. So it's max of the maximum number of pixels that the camera has captured. One other thing you want to look at up here is color space. So you want to check. Now it would default to the color space that was set in your camera. And if you wanted to change the color space, you can do that here. I usually keep it at Adobe RGB, and I usually change it within Photoshop. And the other thing is the depth. Now the bit depth, you've got two options here. You've got 16 bits and you've got 8 bits. Now basically what it means is that a 16-bit image has much more color depth, much more color information within the image. If you change it to 8, you will reduce that. So when editing, especially in RAW, you want to keep it at 16 bits. Okay, so it's a quick recap. Bit depth you want at 16, if you've shot it at 16. If you haven't shot it at 16, then you're stuck with 8. So you should always shoot in 16-bit if you can. Adobe RGB color space, or whatever color space you shot it in. And make sure this box is unticked, so you will export at your default resolution, 22.1 megapixels. Okay? Now once you've done all your editing over here, again, double check down here that you've got this set at your maximum resolution, then you can open the image. Now when you've opened the image into Photoshop, you can be sure that you are opening the image at its maximum resolution. Right, so once you're open in Photoshop, when you want to look at the image resolution in Photoshop, you go to Image and Image Size, and you get the same information here. Now, don't be confused with this. Image size up here is the document size within Photoshop. It's not the image size as such. What you want to look at now are dimensions. Okay, so you see here, you can choose to look at your dimensions as a percentage, physical size, inches, centimeters, or pixels. And then when you do that, again down here you've got your pixel count. So we got the same again, 5760 3840, at 300 pixels per inch. Now once again up here you've got fit to. Now if you've got it set to original size, then it's going to fit to the original size and resolution that was shot at in camera. So you can change this again, but the best thing really is to do everything manually rather than rely on any of these presets. But you have options there if you want to. So if you want to resize the image to a specific resolution here, if you want to set it at a specific size like A4 or 4x6 or something like that. But if you want to work manually, then this is the way to do it. So you've got this fit to, as we've just shown here, width, height, resolution in pixels per inch, and a resample function. Okay, so let me walk you through those now. Now you'll see this little button here. If we hover over it, it says do not constrain aspect ratio. If we uncheck that, then that basically means that what I can do is change that without affecting the height. And what will happen there, if I click OK, it's just going to distort my image. So I'll undo that. And check that. So you want to make sure that's checked, unless for any reason you want to do that. But now, if you see, if I change my image resolution, it will, for the width, it will also change the height. So it will maintain the aspect ratio of your image. Okay, let's undo that. Okay, now, as I said before, resolution. This is the amount of pixels that are spread within 1 inch of your scene. So basically, this total number of pixels are then spread in blocks of 300. Now, 300 pixels per inch is typically the size that images are printed at. But when we use images on the internet, or in web browsers, now if we go up to this thing here, you may see down here options for 72 ppi as well. And that 72 ppi is, or dpi, or pixels per inch, or dots per inch, however you want to call it, it means the same thing. 72 ppi is used in web browsers. Now, even if you have your image set at 300 pixels per inch, if you open it in a web browser, the web browser will only show it in 72 dots per inch. And it will actually resize the image to fit on the screen or to fit within the box or container of your website. So uploading an image at 300 dpi makes no difference at all. But setting your dpi or ppi to 300 pixels per inch when printing will make a difference, or to 400 or to 500, because then it will increase the sharpness and the detail of the print. But when it comes to uploading to the internet, it makes no difference, because an internet browser will always display your image at 72 pixels per inch. So what we really want to look at, especially when you're uploading to the internet, if you're building a website, or if you're putting your images on display in your website or on web pages, then it's the pixel count that matters in this case, because it's always going to be displayed at 72 dpi. So you want to look at the pixel count. Now, if you change the pixel count, for example, okay, you can increase, but then you can increase the pixel count and you can decrease the pixel count. If you decrease the pixel count, well, basically Photoshop removes a bunch of the pixels and resizes the image down. Now that's okay, because you're decreasing the resolution. But if you increase the pixel count, you are increasing the image resolution. And of course, if you're increasing, Photoshop needs to add pixels. And what it does is it uses something called interpolation. It basically adds pixels to increase the size of your image. Now you lose image quality when you do this. Now Photoshop's very good at upsizing, and very good if you have a very high quality image to start with, sometimes it can do a pretty good job of upsizing the image. But sometimes, depends on how big you want to upsize it to, you have to be a bit careful in this respect. But that's where this resample button comes in. You see, if we hover over it now, it says interpolate the pixel information. So if we resample the image, then Photoshop is either adding or taking away. If it's adding, it's going to add pixels. If it's decreasing, it's going to remove pixels as such. So when you do that, you want to make sure that you're choosing the right button here. If you're going to reduce, then you should use, as it says here, the bicubic sharper option for reduction. If you're going to enlarge, then you want to use either preserve details enlargement or bicubic smoother enlargement. Okay, and there are other options there as too. Or you can choose automatic to let Photoshop decide for you, depending on what you're doing. So let's just run through this now. So with the resample function on, let's look, for example, at the difference between resolution and image size or print size. This would be. So at a resolution of 300 pixels per inch, at the maximum pixel count of 5760 or 23 megapixels, if we now go to centimeters, we can see that that is now a 48.77 centimeter wide image at 300 pixels per inch. If I take that down to 1000 now, I've now got 1000 pixels on my longest side at a resolution of 300 pixels per inch. If I now go to centimeters, it's now telling me that the print size of my image is 8.47 centimeters. So I've made my image smaller. Let's go back. Yeah, if you ever want to go back, just go to here and click back to original size. Okay. Let's put that back again. So if I want to increase, so let's say I want to take that up to 8,000 pixels. If I now look at my image size, I've now got a 67 centimeter wide image. Okay, and in which case, if I did that, I would want to choose preserve details or smoother to enlarge the image. Back to original size, check that again. Okay, now, same thing here. If I want to change my resolution, if I want to increase that, if I take it up to 400, because I'm using the resample function, I've automatically increased the pixel count to do that. If I want to take that down to 72, I've automatically decreased the pixel count to do that. I take that back to 300. Okay. Now, basically, because we've got the resample function on, if I've said I want an image with 72 pixels per inch, it's now resized that image down because I'm reducing the number of pixels within that square. Same if I do 400. Now I'm saying that I want more than 300 pixels per inch, and because I've got the resample function on, it's then adding and interpolating more pixels to give me 400 pixels per inch. Okay, let's go back to original size again. Now if I uncheck this resample function, now what will happen is if I say that I want 400, yeah. Notice now it's changing the size, centimeters. But notice how I no longer have the option to look at the pixels. It's gone to dimensions only. And notice up here, the dimensions don't change. If I take that to 72, it's still a 5760 wide. There's still 5760 pixels along the width, but at 72 dpi. So it hasn't actually resized my image. It hasn't changed the number of pixels. I've still got the maximum resolution here. But by setting a resolution of 72, it's now saying that for print, it will give me a print size of 203 centimeters wide. If I take that up to 400, I can increase the resolution. I can increase the pixel count per inch of my image, which will give me a slightly smaller print size. So 36 centimeters at 300, 48 centimeters at 200, 97 centimeters at 150. And in each case, the actual total pixel count of my image isn't changing because I have unchecked that resample function. So this is a very good way to especially if you're going to print. This is not so important when it comes to uploading to the internet, because as I said, it will always be at 72 pixels per inch. And if you upload to the internet, it doesn't really matter if you set that to 72 or if you set that to 300, because the browser will always change it to 72. What matters for the internet is the pixel count, which we'll look at in a minute. But what matters for print is resolution. So you want to look at the print size that you want to make, and then you want to look at the resolution. So actually a good way to, if you want, for example, to make a print that is, if you, let's say you want to make a 30 centimeter wide print. You could change that to 30, and if this is unchecked, it will automatically change your PPI, but it won't strip out any of the pixels in your image. So you maintain maximum image quality when printing this way. If I want to print it at 20, you can take it to 20, and it will change the image resolution to 731 pixels per inch, but give you a print of 20 centimeters by 13 centimeters. At the maximum resolution. So when printing, this is the thing to do. So let's go back again to original size. Just to recap, change the resolution, you change the print size, but you don't change the maximum number of pixels within your image. Change the print size, it changes the pixel count, pixels per inch automatically. Again, that doesn't change. Okay, put that, tick that resample function back, and then now you'll see that if I want to change that down to 20 centimeters, now you'll see my pixel count has changed up here because it's resampling. It's going to resize my image down, but it's also going to strip out the number of pixels within my image. Again, as I said, if you're doing this for the internet, that's not a problem. But if you're doing it for print, well, it's not necessarily a problem. But if you want to maintain the maximum number of pixels within your print, then you want to make sure that this is unchecked, so you don't change that. So, pixel count. That's the thing we want to look at for uploading to the internet. So, as an example, let's set an image at, let's say, 800 pixels at 300 pixels per inch. Now you can see that that image has been instantly resized. Now, another thing you need to note is if you want to save this, remember to save as, you won't see an option here for JPEG, or except this JPEG 2000. You'll only see an option for TIFFs, Photoshop, large formats, things like that. Now that is because it's 16-bit. See this number 16 here, and a 16-bit image cannot be saved as a JPEG. So when you want to save it as a JPEG, you want to go to mode and change it to 8 bits. Now, the reason I say open in 16 bits is when you're doing all of your photo editing, you want to edit a 16-bit file. And what I typically do is I always save mine as TIFFs, and I keep a high resolution 16-bit TIFF that I can always work on. If I ever want to do any editing, I work on that, or I work on the raw file, and then I save as a JPEG, and I never edit the JPEG. If I want to go back and do any more editing, then I either go back, I edit the TIFF, or I edit the raw. So to save as a JPEG, mode 8-bit. Now you can save as, and what we'll do is we'll save it in this folder, okay, and we'll call that 300 ppi. Okay, now let's uncheck the resample function here, change that to 72, okay, and now let's look at our document. Okay, sorry, change that to 72. Now we're still 800 pixels, but we're at 72 pixels per inch. Let's click that, save as, and we'll save that as 72. Now notice the image size didn't change then, because it's still 800 pixels wide, whether it's at 72 ppi or whether it's at 300 ppi on screen. If we go now and look at those two files, we can open them in a browser. So if we go to open with, choose another app, let's open them in Internet Explorer or Firefox. Let's say Firefox. There you go. There's the image size. Now, if we open the 300 ppi, again, in Firefox, notice it's the same size. There's no difference, is there? If I now go back and let's resample, let's now change that to 400 at 72. Save as. We just call that 400 pixels. Now we're looking at the pixels, not the PPI, the number of pixels on the width, on the long side. Save that as. Let's now open this again. Firefox. Now we have a smaller image. See? 800, 400. And again, I can do the same thing here. I can go to image size, uncheck the resample function, change that to 300, still got 400 pixels. Save that as 300 ppi. And there we have it again, see? It's the same size. Whether it's 300 ppi or whether it's 72 ppi. On screen, in a browser, it doesn't make a difference to the size. Now, this is important to know if you're building your own website. If you're uploading images to your own website and you're trying to set sizes on the website, it's important to know that the ppi doesn't matter. The pixel count is what matters when displaying in web browsers or when displaying on the internet. But the PPI matters when you're printing. That's the difference. That's the big difference there. Now, one thing I would say here, if you're uploading your image to pods or anything like that, places where you're going to sell, then you don't want to do this. You want to upload the full resolution image, because then the pod site will do all the resizing and setting the images for display. But the image that you want to upload is the full resolution, full size image. PPI won't matter when you're uploading, because when they send it to print, the printer will set the PPI. And when they display it on the internet, as I said, it will always be displayed at 72, so the pod's website software or whatever it is going to do all that for you. So it doesn't matter. What matters is that if you're uploading to a pod or a place where you want to sell your image, then you want to upload the full size image. If you're uploading your image to a website that you're building yourself that you want to display, then you want to set the pixel count. So that's what's important there. If you're uploading to somewhere like SmugMug, of course, then again, that doesn't matter, because with SmugMug, they do it all for you. So you can upload your full size images, and you can also, it's very useful on SmugMug if you have a SmugMug account. If you upload the full size JPEG, then it also acts as storage for your image too. But then SmugMug, the software will do all of the resizing for you, so you don't have to worry about that. Okay, so I hope that's made the concept of image resolution a bit clearer for you. And as always, thanks for watching, and check out my other videos if you can, or if you want to. And if you haven't subscribed, I'd really appreciate it if you do subscribe. And if you enjoyed this video, please give it a like. Okay, thanks again, and catch you later.